Hi, my name is Ted Vail. I grew up as a Republican and was a GOP legislative assistant in Congress, but the GOP moved so far to the right over the years that I became a Democrat without really changing any of my political beliefs. I'm a lawyer, and during the Vietnam War, I was a Navy JAG officer. My ancestors emigrated to America in the early 1600s, and Lieutenant Pelletiah Everett, who was a Minuteman with Paul Revere and later served under George Washington, is my great-great-great-grandfather. Democracies in the past have only lasted for about 250 years, and ours will be 250 in 2026. It's imperative we elect leaders who ensure its survival. So as we approach the 2024 election, it is helpful to remind ourselves what a disaster Trump was as president from 2017 to 2021. So here are my top 10 reasons why Donald Trump is unfit for office. Number one, Trump inspired and was indicted for causing the 1/6 insurrection. Donald has yet to be called to account for his actions and inactions that resulted in the January 6th Capitol riots. If he's elected again in November, he will shut down all pending charges against him. He has promised to pardon many of the insurrectionists, thwarting all accountability. Number two, Trump showed total incompetence during the COVID crisis. How were you feeling 4 years ago today during the COVID pandemic? Remember when Trump pontificated publicly about the possibility of injecting bleach in our bodies to fight the virus? Or how he constantly seemed to undermine our public health officials? Over 270 million Americans have been vaccinated, largely due to the efforts of Dr. Fauci, the FDA, and the Biden-Harris administration. And the pandemic is thankfully behind us. We cannot let incompetent Trump become our president again and inject bleach into the next crisis. Number three, Trump clearly admires dictators and wants to become one himself. Donald has repeatedly praised Russia's Putin, North Korea's Kim Jong-un, and China's Xi for their dictatorial control over their countries. I worry that Trump will imprison journalists who criticize him, and he paints a picture of building huge detention camps for 10 million undocumented immigrants, separating families all over again. It took Hitler 19 months to turn 1933 Germany from a democracy into a dictatorship, and it would take Trump much less time if he's given the chance. Number four, Trump does not respect women and their human rights. Donald has been found guilty of sexual abuse and ordered to pay huge damages to E. Jean Carroll for assaulting her. His Project 2025 will impact women and gender equality immensely, jeopardizing the lives of my daughters, my granddaughter, and millions more, gutting access to abortion, Planned Parenthood, and Head Start, and other such programs. The GOP used to believe in keeping the government out of the lives of Americans, but now they support the most intrusive interference in our lives possible. Trump and his allies want to control women's bodies, and they want to tell us which books to read. Number five, Trump refused to return classified documents when he left office, and we don't know why. Trump took more than 340 classified documents with him when he went back to Mar-a-Lago and stored the secret documents where tens of thousands of visitors could have had access to them. He refused to return them when the National Archives requested that they be returned. Why? Did he keep these documents to have future bragging rights? To help him write his memoirs? Or to sell them to the highest bidder or pass them on to an enemy of America to curry political favor? If Trump is elected, we will never find out why he took those secrets, because he would have the Justice Department dismiss the classified documents case. Number six, Trump imposed unnecessary tax cuts to benefit himself and his rich friends and added $8.4 trillion to the already too high national debt. Donald lowered the top corporate tax rate from 28% to 21%, and the top 1% will receive a $60,000 tax cut in 2025. So far, nothing has really trickled down to the middle class, and Trump has no respect for a balanced budget. Biden-Harris, on the other hand, passed laws to reduce the deficit by $3 trillion over 10 years. Number 7, Trump will continue to fill the federal courts with loyalists and right-wing zealots. Donald appointed 3 very conservative judges to the Supreme Court during his one term, changing the court from a 5-4 liberal majority to a 6-3 right-wing majority, which has done a lot to damage the American way of life. His court has overturned Roe v. Wade, taking away women's rights to abortions established 50 years ago. It also ruled that presidents have immunity for their official acts, and it gutted public corruption law, allowing gifts and rewards to public officials after the fact. He wants to remake the entire federal judiciary in his image. A classic example is Trump getting Eileen Cannon confirmed to the federal bench in November 2020, just after he lost the election. She is the judge who recently dismissed the classified documents case against Trump in a badly reasoned opinion, unlike every other court that has ruled on the issue. Number 8, Trump supports Americans owning deadly assault weapons. Donald has no plan to end the plague of gun violence. He does not care about our children who must routinely undergo mass shooting drills in their schools. He would let the National Rifle Association run wild with concealed carry authorizations and the unlicensed ownership of guns throughout the country. Trump would make common sense gun reform impossible if he is elected. Number 9, Trump does not respect our planet. He wants to dismantle the environmental regulations that protect our clean air and clean water. He also denies climate change. My grandson will be my age in the year 2102. What kind of world will exist if Trump eliminates our environmental protections? Number 10, his reckless foreign policy is a danger to the world. Should Donald be elected, he plans to withdraw from NATO, according to his national security advisor, John Bolton, allowing Putin to overrun Ukraine and plunge us into a third world war in Europe. Trump's isolationist policy would also give the green light to China to overrun Taiwan, inflaming the risk of a global war. If elected, Trump may overhaul the military and the federal bureaucracy and fill key positions with loyalists, thereby eliminating any checks and balances to his megalomania. In conclusion, Trump is grossly unfit for office and lacks common decency and a moral compass. But don't take my word for it. Many of his prior cabinet officials and members of his first administration, including his own vice president, have publicly come out to say Trump is unfit and unqualified, and they do not endorse him for another term as president. It makes sense. Those who work closest to him know how terribly damaged he is. I have not even talked about Trump's racist dog whistles, his praise of white nationalists after Charlottesville, and his own efforts to undermine immigration reform. A Republican-backed bill was ready for passage until he sabotaged it to be able to continue attacking immigration in his campaign, impeding any bipartisan solutions. Not only will defeating Trump spare us from 4 more years of chaos, it will preserve our democracy. This will also allow the Republican Party to purge itself of Trump and refocus on principled conservatism. We can't go back to the turmoil that reigned during Trump's last presidency. We need a president and vice president who understand what is at stake for our country after almost 250 years as a democracy. And Kamala Harris and Tim Walz do. It is truly a cop versus a con this November. Thank you for watching, and make sure you vote.